Thank you. developing athletes to be foundationally strong. Healthy and consistent training. Expert staff. Long-term athletic development. Parkview Sports Medicine Performance. Any athlete, any age, any skill level.
Thank you for watching Summit City Sports. To help broaden our coverage, we're asking you to become a monthly sponsor to our Patreon account. We produce weekly highlights and live video broadcast. When the Homestead girls golf team won its first state title in program history, we were there. When Fort Wayne brought back three state titles in cross country, we were there. We believe in sharing positive stories and setting the standard for how high school sports should be covered. Join us and donate today.
I chose St. Francis because they made a promise that I would have real world experience that I could take when I graduated, and they delivered on that promise. For me, the classroom only gets you so far. So they're setting you up with an internship. I had a mentor that they set me up with that was a CEO of a DuPont hospital in Fort Wayne.
They offer degrees in accounting, business administration, risk management and insurance, marketing, and finance.
You know, they just did a great job of the full circle of not only the education, but also the experience.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Hutzel Center on the campus of St. Francis. We're coming to you live this afternoon as we will have a Conference Roads League action here for you in girls basketball. The Marian Knights, they are number 9th ranked in the country. They'll travel to take on today against a very good USF Cougars team here at the Hutzel Center. My name is Ryan Dellinger. I'll be your host for this conference matchup between these two big-time foes here in the NAIA. Taking a closer look at the Marian team, they are 10-4 overall, 4-0 in conference play, and they are ranked number 9 in the country. They are coached by Katie Gerald. She's a former standout at Purdue. She's in her 8th season. In her 8 years here, she's amassed a 201-44 record, and in the conference, she's 104-22. That's good for an 83% winning mark. Her team last year won 31 games. They won both the conference title and the tourney title. That was her fourth in 5 years at Marion. Their last game, they beat an Oakland City team 93-45. And their next game after this one, they will play next Wednesday. Actually, this Wednesday, they'll take on Goshen at 7 o'clock at Goshen. Looking at their schedule, they've played a tough schedule thus far. Some of their wins are against the who's who of the NAIA. They have 4 total losses on the season. And those 4 losses are a combined 16 points. Their losses are to St. Francis of Illinois, Lindsey Wilson, Thomas More, and Indiana Tech. Indiana Tech ranked in the top 5 in the NAIA. So Katie Gerald's team once again is outstanding. They're scoring about 77 points a game and giving up less than 60. From the field, they're shooting 47%, 34% behind the arc, and 70% at the line. You look down at their roster here, they've got a lot of good players. They've got size, they've got experience, they've got youth on this team. So a good squad once again for Katie Gerald. We'll take a look at the starting lineups in just a moment. We will, after our first time out here on our Parkview Sports Medicine pregame show. Looking at the home team, the St. Francis Lady Cougars, they are 8-4 overall, 2-1 in conference play. They are they have a very balanced roster this season. They don't rely on one person. They've got multiple players that do a great job, and their head coach is Jason Ridge. He's in his 6th season. He's 93-63 overall, 53-34 in conference play. His team last year was 23-7 and 11-4 in conference play. The last time they played, well, that was a long time ago, boys and girls. All the way back on December the 5th, they were beaten by Indiana Tech 64-60. Interestingly, both of these teams have played Indiana Tech, and both of them have lost, and they've both been within 3 points. Their next game after this one will be Wednesday at Huntington North at 7 p.m. So this should be an interesting game. The Cougars shooting 45% from the field, 36% from behind the arc, and 68% at the foul line. They're averaging 65 points a game and giving up 55. So this game, these two teams are kind of mirror images of each other. The thing is, Marion has a little more size. And we'll talk a little bit more about their size after this break. We'll take a timeout. When we come back, we will have the starting lineups. Your starting lineups today are presented by Parkview Sports Medicine. You're watching college basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
Thank you for watching Summit City Sports. To help broaden our coverage, we're asking you to become a monthly sponsor to our Patreon account. We believe in sharing positive stories and are excited to set the standard for how high school sports should be covered. Join us and donate today.
Welcome back to the Hutzel Center on the campus of the University of St. Francis. Both teams have gone to the locker room, and it's time to meet the starting lineups. Your starting lineups, once again, are presented by Parkview Sports Medicine. First, for the Lady Knights of Marion, they will go at one guard position, a 5'7" senior from Avon, Indiana, number three, Abby Downard. At another guard position, a 6-foot freshman from Danville, Indiana, number 13, Ella Collier. At another guard position, a 5'8" senior from Flora, Indiana, number 32, Macy Willoughby. And at one forward position, a 5'8" freshman from Fishers, Indiana, number 2, Tamia Perriman. And in the middle tonight, a 6'4" senior from Columbus, Indiana, number 23, Amani Guy. A guy stands 6'4". She's formerly played some Division I basketball at Southern Indiana before she transferred to Marion. And she'll be a tough one tonight for the Cougars to stop. She's averaging 14 points a game and 8 rebounds. And she has some help also on the outside from the freshman guard, Collier. Collier, 13 points a game, 4 rebounds. She played her high school ball at Danville High School. And then you look down this roster, Willoughby averaging 7 points a game, along with Downard. She averages 12 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists. She only stands 5'7", so that means she's pretty scrappy. And then the freshman, Perriman, averaging 4 points, 5 rebounds for Katie Gerald's Lady Knights team. Now for the Lady Cougars lineup. And this lineup has basically been their starting lineup for most of the year. They will go at one guard position, a 5'9" senior from Greenwood, Indiana, number 3, Sydney Crow. At another guard position, a 5'7" senior from Fort Wayne, number 11, Deja Hinton. At the one forward position, a 6-foot sophomore from Tipton, Indiana, that's Cassidy Crawford. At the other forward position from Otterville, Ohio, is a 5'9" senior, number 35, Alexis Turbin. And in the middle today, a 6'1" sophomore from Albion, Indiana, number 20, Malia Leatherman. The leading scorer for the Cougars, Cassidy Crawford. She's been that since day one. She has kept that moniker, and she is leading the team with 12.6 rebounds, 2 assists. They don't have another player that averages in double figures, but what they do have is 3 more that average 9 points a game. Sydney Crow, along with Leatherman, and Leatherman's beginning to come on a little bit stronger here at the end of the tail end of the first half of the season, along with Reagan Pate. She comes off the bench. She's like the Vinnie Johnson of this team. She just comes right in and scores points. So she's a very good player. Turbin averaging 4 points a game, and Deja Hinton averaging 5 points a game. And I'm sure Coach Jason Ridge would really like to get Hinton off going good from the outside. She was a little bit quiet towards the end of the first half of the season, and would really like to get her going, but they also have some good players on the bench. This team is a deep team. They can bring in Whitney Will. She does a nice job. She can play both inside and outside. She can shoot it a little bit as well. Elise Skaggs, you'll hear her name this afternoon. And also Aubrey Dunnick, another name to watch off the bench today for the Cougars. Well, both of these two teams this is a conference game here. Both of them want to get off to a good one. The Cougars here, they want to make sure Marion gets their first loss of the season in conference play. And Marion wants to continue their hot streak at 4-0 in conference play. And you look at these two teams' schedules. I looked at them both before the game. Once today is over, they will play just about 2 to 3 times a week from this point on until about February the 6th. So this is a nonstop time of the year for both of these teams. And today, one of these teams wants to get the advantage in the Crossroads League, as it's all conference play, basically, from this point on in the season. We'll take our final time out here on the Parkview Sports Medicine pregame show. When we come back, we will have the starters with the public address announcer when we get back. You're watching college basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
Sure, we have to do this. A bit of a hill.
His mother said, if you're coming to school, you got to bring your sister because they have to go and work in the fields. So this kid carries his one-year-old sister everywhere.
A lot of those kids don't eat in the morning. A lot of those kids, the only place they do eat is at that school.
I thought going up that mountain, Mary's meals can reach everywhere that there's a hungry child.
Do you see what happens after a simple meal? It just came to life.
Love reaches everywhere.
Parkview Sports Medicine's integrated sports medicine team is built to serve the needs of all athletes in all sports. Our team's only goal is to improve athletes in every facet. PSM offers performance training to help athletes get better on the field, dedicated athletic rehabilitation and physical therapy to help them get better off of it. Certified athletic trainers in our PSM schools providing daily support to our athletes and a specialized orthopedic walk-in clinic when injury strikes. Call 260-266-4007 to speak to our care navigators or visit ParkviewSportsMedicine.com to learn more about what we can do to improve athletes at all levels. Parkview Sports Medicine. Become more.
Welcome to the Summit City, home to the 260's dedicated high school athletes and fans. Each victory and celebration captured by our camera. Treasure the highlights from the Summit Athletic Conference this season or complete games live or on demand. After all, nobody's more proud to call Fort Wayne home than SummitCitySports.com.
Joint pain, sprains, strains, or a possible broken bone? Make the Parkview Ortho Express Walk-In Clinic your first stop when you have an orthopedic or sports injury. Parkview Ortho Express, located at the Sport One Parkview Fieldhouse, gives you access to quick care and orthopedic physicians when you need it most. Get x-rays, treatment, and referrals to Parkview Care, all in the convenience of a walk-in clinic. Call 260-266-4007 for more information.
I was once a Southside kid who was led on a journey by high school football. A journey that taught me discipline, toughness, and the skills that made me a success. As a businessman with a CPA license who owns his own firm, I still use the building blocks of high school sports in my everyday life. Someday sports will end no matter what level you reach, but you will be left with the skills to compete in the next game, the game of life.
Someday, you'll get your knee replaced. Someday, a new hip. Someday can be sooner than you think. At Parkview Ortho Hospital, we want to help you get moving again. So we offer a full range of options for joint pain, including outpatient joint replacements and personalized solutions. It's time to reclaim your life at Parkview Ortho Hospital, because someday is today. Learn more at parkview.com/ortho. Parkview, we believe in better.
Thank you for watching Summit City Sports. To help broaden our coverage, we're asking you to become a monthly sponsor to our Patreon account. We produce weekly highlights and live video broadcast.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we ask for your blessing on the game about to be played. Give each of the players, coaches, officials the courage to compete in a manner in which words and actions are pleasing to you. Bless each of us, the players, coaches, officials, and staff throughout today's game. Keep us under your protection, and in the words of St. Francis, enlighten our hearts, give us a right faith, a sure hope, and a perfect charity. Amen. Now the playing of our national anthem. At forward is going to be a freshman from Fisher's Indiana, number two, Sophia Harris. At guard, a 5'7 senior from Avon, Indiana, number three, Abby Downs. At guard, a 6-foot freshman from Bakeville, Indiana, number 13, Ella Collier. At forward, a 6-foot senior from Columbus, Indiana, number 23, Amani Dye. And at guard, a 5'8 senior from Florida, Indiana, number 32, Mason Dooley. Head coach of the Knights, Katie Gerald, she's assisted by Vicky Bolanowski, Lincoln Hensel Smith, and Jenna Sullivan. And now, the starting lineup for your University of St. Francis Lady Cougars. Entering today's play with a record of 8-4 overall, 2-1 at Crossroads, New Hampshire. At 4-6, the sophomore from Tipton, Indiana, number 4, Cassidy Crawford. At guard, a 5'9 senior from Greenwood, Indiana, number 5, Sydney Crow. At guard, a 5'7 senior from Fort Wayne, number 11, Jason Hinton. At center, a 6-1 sophomore from Albany, Indiana, number 20, Malia Leatherman. And at forward, a 5'9 senior from Ottawa, Indiana, Ohio, number 35, Alexis Turbin. Head coach of the Lady Cougars.
Once again, your starters for Marion, they will go with Perriman, Downard, Collier, Guy, and Willoughby. For the home team, the Cougars, they will go with Crawford, Crow, Hinton, Leatherman, and Turbin. The officials are on the court, and we are ready to go for Crossroads League action here this afternoon at the Hutzel Center. Once again, my name is Ryan Dellinger, and it's going to be a busy time here for St. Francis. We're going to have a lot of basketball games on between men's and women's. Next week, we've got a full slate of basketball. Men's game will be on I believe it's Monday night at 7 o'clock here at the Hutzel Center. So we are set and ready to go. Malia Leatherman in the circle already for the Cougars. The Cougars in their white uniforms, blue numbers, letters, and accents today. And Marion in their navy blue and yellow uniforms. And that is Amani Guy, who's about 4 inches taller than Malia Leatherman. And both teams are set and ready to go. The officials got the ball. And we are ready to go. And here's the tip, controlled by Marion. Donnard with it now, and the Cougars will start with a man-to-man defense. And they'll go a little too low here for Marion. Here's a drive by Donnard. She'll go all the way through the lane, kicks it outside. Three ball on the way, no good. Good block out there by Leatherman on Guy. That shot was by number 32, Willoughby. Here's a good look inside, and they'll say a turnover on the Cougars, their first of the game. That shot last time was by number 32, Willoughby of Marion. Donnard with the ball now. She'll give it up to Collier. Collier get a high screen. She'll stop. She'll fire a long three, and it's nothing but nylon. And Marion will pick up full court now. Crawford inbounds it to Leatherman. Back over to Crawford. They'll need to get somebody in the middle, and they've got Crow in there. Across the timeline now to Turbin. Turbin quickly over to Crawford, and they'll reset their offense with 20 seconds to play here. Or 20 seconds on the shot clock as Hinton has it on the left wing. She'll get a screen. Good edge there by Guy. They'll look inside and another turnover. Here comes Collier the other way. She just hit a three. She'll slow it up now. Looks inside. She'll find Perriman. Perriman backs baseline and is fouled from behind by Crawford. On Crawford, that will be her first. And the first couple foul shots coming now for Marion as Perriman, the freshman, goes to the line to shoot. She played her high school ball at Fishers High School. And she's averaging about 4 points a game, shooting about 63% from the line, and then she gets the first one to roll around and go in. And Perriman with the second one. It's on its way. It's a line drive, and it's good. Marion out to an early 5-0 lead. Crawford with it now. It's a man-to-man full-court press. Turbin has it. She'll ball fake. Has it tipped from behind. Goes on the floor. Loses it to Marion. A quick throw inside to Guy, but picked off there by Hinton. So a turnover on Marion. Their first of the game. And Hinton with the ball. Now nobody picked her up. She'll give it up to Turbin. And she'll look to the corner now. She'll find Hinton. Hinton gets a screen from Leatherman. Leatherman turned the wrong way, and another turnover on the Cougars. Collier the other way. She'll go right to the hoop, throws it up with the left hand, and it'll go in. Collier with five. And a quick timeout on the court. St. Francis will use one as well. You're watching Cougars basketball live from the University of St. Francis. Run to get started here in the first minute and 34 seconds for Marion. They're out to a big lead. They lead by seven. Collier already with five. And the Cougars will inbounds under the Marion basket here. It'll be Crawford to inbounds. Now they'll bring everybody into the backcourt this time. And they'll get it in now to Leatherman. Leatherman slows it up. Back to Crawford. Crawford now over the half-court line, and she'll give it up to Hinton. Cougars have yet to even get a shot off. Leatherman this time, she'll fire the long jumper. It's short. And Collier with the board. She'll give it up to Donard, and Donard into the front court now and over to Willoughby. Willoughby goes baseline, gets cut off there by Crow. Back up top, now to Collier. She'll drive on Crawford, gets cut off, and gives it to Perriman. Perriman outside to Donard, and 16 on the shot clock. Collier with another long three. It's a line drive, and she gets the shooter's roll again. Collier now with eight. Crawford now for St. Francis. She wants to drive on Perriman, gets down low, throws it up off the glass, misses it, gets her own board. And now she's trapped down there by Perriman. She's going to have to give it up. The five-second clock is on. She'll throw it up with the left hand. Misses everything, and it comes down to Perriman. Perriman now into the front court for Marion. She'll give it up to Collier. Collier back over to Willoughby. She'll fire a three. It's no good. Hinton has a rebound, and she's fouled from behind by Donard. And we see into the game Aubrey Dunnick and number 22 Pate in for the first time. They'll replace Turbin and Hinton. And Collier's going to draw Miss Pate here in the half-court defense. Crawford quickly into the front court. She gives it up to Crow. Crow goes up off the glass. She's fouled. She'll shoot a pair. And we'll see who the Marion foul is on. Looks like they're going to call it on 23 Guy. Sydney Crow had me confused before the game. She went from a lighter shade of hair to a red shade of hair, and the SID helped me figure out who she was. She misses the front end of the two shots. Cougars yet to get on the board here. They trail 10 to nothing. Crow for the free throw. Misses it. Good rebound there by Leatherman. Back outside to Crow. She'll drive. Goes right around the defense, and they're going to call her for a travel. The Cougars with five early turnovers here in the first half. Katie Gerald's up off the bench, talking to her point guard, and here comes Marion with the 10-0 lead. I'll run a little box formation here, and they're going to call a foul on Dunnick. Dunnick with her first personal, team second. Marion will inbounds under their own bucket with 6:36 to go here in the first quarter. It'll be Donard who will inbounds. She'll get it into Willoughby. Willoughby looks inside. Nobody there. Back to the point guard. Guy's going to set a screen for her on Crow. Crow gets around that screen. Kicked outside and tipped out of bounds by Dunnick. Good defense there by Aubrey Dunnick. Now Marion will switch up their inbounds. They'll run a box formation. They'll look to get it in. They'll find Perriman. She'll throw it inside. Has it knocked away by Dunnick, and they'll give it now to Willoughby and now to Guy. Guy goes baseline, gets cut off, and she stepped out of bounds. Two turnovers now on Marion, and the Cougars with the ball, trailing 10 to nothing. Inbounded now to Dunnick. Dunnick takes one dribble and back to Crawford. Crawford into the front court. She picks up her dribble. Now she's trapped, and she'll give it to Pate. Pate's tangled up there with Collier, and it's a tie-up. The ball will stay with the Cougars as Whitney Will will check in. Excuse me, that's Elise Skaggs up off the bench, and she'll replace Leatherman. Perriman thought they had the ball. Now Dunnick will inbounds for the Cougars. She'll get it in now to Crawford. Crawford with the ball now to Pate. Pate now to Skaggs. Skaggs will fire the 17-footer, and she'll hit it. And the Cougars are on the board. Donard with the ball now to Perriman. She'll give it up to Willoughby. Willoughby in the corner now to the point guard. And back up top to Perriman. She's going to fire a long three. It's off the iron. Dunnick with the board, and she'll push it in transition now for the Cougars. She'll give it up now to Pate. Now over to Crow. She'll fire the long jumper, and here comes the Cougars. Big three by Sydney Crow. And now Collier the other way, and she drains a two. Had to look over at the official first before I called that. Wasn't sure if she was inside the arc or not, and she was. Crawford back outside, now to Crow, and Dunnick with it, now to Pate. Pate looks inside, nothing there, back to Dunnick. Dunnick will drive to the bucket, and that's going to be an offensive, oh no, they're going to call it travel. It was better a travel than what was going to probably be called there, would be an offensive foul. Marion will go to their bench now. They'll go with number 42, Gerard. Number 5, McCour. And they checked somebody else in, too. I'm trying to figure out who that was. And this young lady with the ball right now, her ponytail's not letting me see. It's number 1, Wiener. There's a good look inside the guy. She'll go up strong. She's bumped on the bottom side there by Crawford. Crawford's going to pick up her second personal, and that's going to send Marion back to the line. The Cougars brought back in Deja Hinton at the whistle, and here comes Leatherman back on for the Cougars, and she'll have to replace Crawford in those two fouls. 4:42 to play here in the first quarter. Guy's free throw is good. Second one on the way. He's got a little hard off the back of the iron, hitting with the rebound. She'll cover up the ball now. Now looks up the court. She was looking for Skaggs, couldn't get it to her. Right side now to Pate. Pate will get a screen there by Skaggs. Good defense by the Knights. And it's a turnover, and here comes Marion. They'll lose it. Elise Skagg comes up with a loose ball up off the glass, and she cuts into the 7-point lead. Skaggs off the bench with 4 points for St. Francis. That goes off of Gerard's fingertips and out of bounds. And here comes Willoughby back in for Marion. And she's going to give, I believe, Guy a rest, and she will take a quick breather here at the 4:11 mark of the first quarter. Skaggs will run back and inbounds now for St. Francis. She'll give it up to Dunnick. Dunnick now goes to the right side, gives it up to Pate. Pate around the screen, gives it right to Skaggs. Skaggs now turns, goes right to the hoop, has it partially blocked, comes up with it, underneath now to Dunnick, and she is fouled there by number 5, McCour. And that will send the Cougars back to the line to shoot a pair. Aubrey Dunnick will stand at the line to shoot for St. Francis. Dunnick on the season is a 63% foul shooter. Her first offering on the way is good. Dunnick's second one. Short, and it comes down to Gerard. Winner with it. She'll give it up to Collier. They'll look inside. They'll find Gerard. She'll post, and she'll throw it into the front row. Nice to see fans here at the Hutzel Center. We've gone here in Allen County from a red county down to orange, which does allow some family members into not only college sports, but high school sports now here in Northeast Indiana. So Dunnick with the ball. 3:30 to go here in quarter number one. She'll give it up to Hinton. Hinton behind the back. She'll drive to the bucket. Gets around the defender, off the glass, and hits a shot. Deja Hinton with the big bucket for St. Francis. And this is the closest St. Francis has been in a long time. Outside now. Makura will go baseline. She runs right over a player, off the fingertips of Gerard, and picked off once again by Hinton. Now over to Dunnick. She sees a lane, goes to the hoop. She's fouled on the hip, and she'll shoot a pair. We'll see who the night follows on. 42 is going to get called for the foul. Gerard, that is her first, team's third. Turbin will check in. She'll replace Pate. And into the game for Marion, number three, Donnard. And we've got a timeout on the court. And we will use one as well. You're watching Cougars basketball live from the Hutzel Center. Timeout over here at the Hutzel Center. The Cougars trail by three to Marion. Marion got out to a quick 10-0 lead before St. Francis has gone on a bit of a run here. And they've gotten themselves back into this first quarter. We've got an even 3 minutes to play, and it'll be St. Francis, I believe, at the line shooting. Once again, some free throws. Cougars just one of four so far from the line, and I believe it's Aubrey Dunnick who will go to the line to shoot. It is. Dunnick's free throw on the way is short. She knew it right away. And here comes Dunnick's second, and this time it's perfect. That'll bring back in Sydney Crow. She'll replace Dunnick. Dunnick with 2 points here in the first half. Winner with it now. Over to the point guard, Donnard. She'll get a high screen here by Gerard. Now over to Winner. She'll go baseline. The little floater on the way, no good. Rebounded there by Skaggs. Skaggs quickly to Sidney Crow, and here comes Crow into the front court to Turbin. She'll look inside. Leatherman is fouled on the floor by number 42, Gerard. Gerard with the hold. And that is 14 fouls now on Marion. One more foul, and St. Francis will be shooting a pair, and here comes Imani Guy back into the game, and she's going to replace Gerard in those two fouls. It'll be Sydney Crow to inbounds with 2:38 to play here in quarter number one. She looks, triggers it in now to Skaggs. Skaggs will give it up to Hinton. Hinton back to Skaggs. Ooh, good pass there by Hinton. Just an eyelash too far, though. Right idea. Skaggs just couldn't come up with it. Cougars now with 7 turnovers. And here comes Marion with the ball with 2:25 to go here in quarter number one. Makura with it now. She'll get a high screen around the screen, right to the rack. Off the glass, she's fouled, and she hits the shot. Take a look at that on replay. And that foul was on number 20, Leatherman, her first, team's fourth. McCour out of South Jordan, Utah. Her free throw on the way is off the back of the iron, right to Skaggs. And here comes Turbin with the ball now. Right side now to Hinton. Back over to Turbin. She can shoot from out there. Good look inside now to Leatherman. She'll skip past it to Crow. Crow's already hit 1-3. No good. Got flattened on that play. No call and tipped and controlled by Marian. Donner now to Willoughby. Willoughby will pick up a dribble. And now throws it inside to Guy. Guy will get post position. Turns, fires, and it goes in and out. Skaggs with another board. Here comes Turbin. She'll fire it ahead. Right to Hinton. Hinton sees the C's part, and she throws it up and hits a layup. Deja Hinton with the circus play here in quarter number one. Threw it right up over Guy, who's saying 6'4". Willoughby will fire a jumper. No good. And Hinton with another board. Her and Skaggs have cleaned up the boards here in the first quarter for St. Francis. And that's a travel on Turbin. She wanted to throw it to Crow. Crow was going to cut to the basket, and she had to pick up her dribble. In for the Cougars comes Dunnick and Pate. Also for Marion, they'll come back with Collier. Number 25 will be in. Bossy. And she'll see her first action here in the first half. We've got 1 minute to go. Here's Collier with the ball. She'll look inside, finds her guard. This ball's tipped out of bounds by Dunnick. Dunnick all over the place on defense. Donnard inbounds. She'll give it to Guy. Guy back to Donnard. She'll turn, give it right back to Guy. Guy turns, gets double teamed, fires it over to McCour. And she'll fire a long three. It's off the iron. No good. Dunnick with the rebound. 47 seconds to go here in the first quarter. She'll look inside for Leatherman. Leatherman quickly over to Skaggs. And she traveled. And Coach Jason Ridge up off the bench telling Miss Pate, come to the ball here. You knew you were going to be open. And come to the open area so they can make that pass to you. That's twice in this first half. That's already happened to the Cougars. Maybe a little rust with as much time as they have had off. No games since December the 5th for St. Francis. We've got 30 seconds to go here in the first quarter. About 7 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Collier will stop it short. And Leatherman with the rebound. And the Cougars can play for the final shot of quarter number one. Dunnick with it now. She'll give it up to Crow. And they can tie or take the lead with this possession. Right back to Aubrey Dunnick. 10 seconds on the clock, and they want her to spread out so Dunnick can go a little one-on-one here. She'll go to the hoop. No foul called, and she got flattened. Here comes Donnard the other way. This shot's good. If it goes, it's off the glass, and it's good. Wow, what a shot at the end of the quarter. We'll take a timeout. When we come back, we'll have the start of the second quarter. You're watching college basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
Joint pain, sprains, strains, or a possible broken bone? Make the Parkview Ortho Express Walk-In Clinic your first stop when you have an orthopedic or sports injury. Call 260-266-4007 for more information.
For every victory, for every highlight, for every team in the Summit Athletic Conference, we've got you covered. Like, follow, and subscribe for all the latest.
My name is Nick Ferrer. I was part of the two-time national championship football team. I graduated from St. Francis with a business degree in risk management insurance. That led me to my internship here at Highland. And that internship became a full-time position as an account manager here at Highland. And if it wasn't for University of St. Francis and the education and the skills that I learned there, I wouldn't be where I'm at today in my career.
Welcome back to the Hutzel Center. Check out this shot if you're just joining us. This is a shot just before the end of the first quarter. This is the senior Abby Donnard who gets this ball. And she decides that she's going to throw one in at the buzzer and says the bank is open, and there it goes. That's her first bucket of the game, and why not? It's a three-pointer for the senior. So we've got ourselves an 18-13 game here, starting quarter number two. The Cougars trailed at one point by 10 points, 10 to nothing, before they decided to go on a bit of a run, a 13-8 run to end that quarter. So back into the game is Perriman, and she'll give it to Donner to hit that big three, along with Bossy and Collier and McCour. The Cougars, they will go with Pate, Leatherman, Dunnick, Crow, and Skaggs. Collier goes to the hoop, and are they going to call an offensive foul or a block? They're going to call. I believe that was Pate or Leatherman with the foul, her second. And that will send Collier to the line to shoot a pair for Marian. Imani Guy will check back in for Marian. Freshman at the line. She'll fire the first one, and it's good. She's already got 11 here in the first half. Her second one on the way is good as well. And we've got a whistle. Turbin will come back on and replace Leatherman. She's got two fouls, so she'll sit. And now Marian will pick up full court once again. It'll be Elise Skaggs to inbounds for St. Francis. And she'll give it up to Turbin. Turbin gets trapped over there. Now back to Skaggs. Skaggs quickly to Dunnick. Dunnick into the front court. She'll throw it back over to Turbin. Up top now to Skaggs. Skaggs looks for Crow. Crow around the screen. Now gets double team. 13 on the shot clock. Skip pass and down low now to Skaggs. Ooh, she had Dunnick. Here comes Crow in the lane. She'll throw up the right-handed runner and it drops. Excuse me, left-handed runner and it drops. Crow with five here in the first half. Donnard with it now. She'll throw across court to Bossy. Back up top to Perriman, and they'll swing it into the corner. Skip pass now to Bossy. She'll drive baseline on Pate. Throws up her own runner. In and out. Perriman with the offensive board and put back. Perriman with four. And that ball is thrown away by St. Francis. Dunnick was looking for Pate and threw it just a bit too far. Right side now to two. Donnard, she'll look inside. Now to Perriman. Perriman over to Collier. Collier back to Perriman. She wants to drive on Turbin. She gets cut off there and gives it back to Donnard. Donnard tries to go right to the hoop. Throws up her own runner. No good. Good rebound by Guy. And she is fouled by, I believe, Elise Skaggs. And our official looking over there. It is on Skaggs. Her first, team second here in quarter number two. That'll send Guy to the line to shoot a pair. On the season, Guy shooting 64% from the line. She's one of two this afternoon. She'll fire the first, and it's no good. Guy's second is good this time, and that'll bring Crawford back in for St. Francis. And she'll have to be careful. She's got two personals. And she'll replace Skaggs. Crawford inbounds, and she'll give it to Crow. Crow back over to Crawford. Crawford will bring it up into the front court. Hands it off to Turbin. Now over to Crow, and now to Dunnick. Dunnick looks inside, couldn't find anybody. Now gets the screen by Crow. Dunnick will go to the hoop, and she is fouled by Perriman. Perriman will pick up her first, a team's first here in quarter number two, and Dunnick will go back to the line to shoot again. Number 21 coming in for Marian, that is Sibe, into the lineup. Aubrey Dunnick back at the line. Dunnick's 2 of 4 from the line. Her first one is in and out. Dunnick played her high school basketball about 25 minutes away at Norwell High School. She'll fire the second, and it's in and out, and Guy with the rebound. Quick outlet now to Dunnard. Dunnard now goes to the hoop, now backs it out. Skip pass now to Bossy. She'll look inside for Guy. Good bounce pass. Quick kick outside to Dunnard. She'll drive. Quick kick outside to Collier, and her three ball is good. Freshman having a good first half here for Marian. She's already got 15. Right side now to Turbin. Not a crow, and she's going to launch her own three. It's short. Guy with those long arms. She tips it to Dunnard, and she'll give it up to Bossy on the left wing. Back to Collier. Nobody picked her up. She'll fire another three, and she hits it. And a timeout on the court, a full timeout by the Cougars. We'll take a timeout. We'll see you in 1 minute. You're watching Cougars basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
Thank you for watching Summit City Sports. To help broaden our coverage, we're asking you to become a monthly sponsor to our Patreon account. We believe in sharing positive stories and are excited to set the standard for how high school sports should be covered. Join us and donate today.
Marion's going on a big run here to get started in quarter number two. They lead by 14 now as St. Francis inbounds on their side of the court. Sydney Crow will inbounds. Going on a 9-2 run to get started here in quarter number two has Marian. Here comes Crow with the ball. She'll look right side for Turbin. They'll look inside now for Crawford. Back outside to Pate. Hinton inside now to Crawford. She'll go up strong. It goes off the glass. No good. And Collier gives it up to Dunnard. Dunnard, good look inside the guy. She'll go up, misses it, gets her own board. Goes up strong again, misses everything, and it comes down to Crow. Here comes St. Francis in transition. Quick outlet now to Hinton. Hinton cross the lane, picks up her own loose ball. And has it taken away by Collier. Collier the other way now for Marian. Willoughby to Guy. Guy back over to Dunnard. 6:30 to go here in the first half. Skip pass now to Willoughby. She thought about the three. And there's 10 seconds on the shot clock. She'll get a screen. Goes around the screen. Goes right back to Guy. Guy will go up and under the bucket. Misses the layup. Tipped and comes down to Pate. Pate quickly ahead for Hinton. Hinton needs a bounce pass here. Good look over to Crawford, and she hits the layup. That's Crawford's first bucket of the game. Collier loses it, picks it up. Gets a screen, now drives to the bucket, gets bumped on the hip, hits the shot, and Collier is just killing St. Francis right now. Deja Hinton with her first personal of the game. She's got 20 here in the first half already. You can just see how strong she is for a freshman. Took the bump on the hip and hit the shot. And that one drops in. Dunnick with it. Now back up top to Hinton. And they'll swing it now to Turbin. Turbin looks inside for Crawford. Skip pass, and it's taken away. Donnard outside, tipped, and comes right to number 21, who's in the game. She'll fire and hit it. That is, Saib with the big bucket. The defense of Marion really causing some havoc for St. Francis. Dunnick with it now. She'll fire the long three. It's off the iron, no good. Guy with the rebound. She'll give it up to Donnard. Back over now to Willoughby. Willoughby in the corner now to Collier. Collier gets a screen. And they'll swing it all the way over to Donnard. She'll launch a three. It's short. Guy with another board. Sure turn. She'll fire. No good. Gets her own rebound. She'll flatten Dunnick. Oh, they're going to call a foul on Aubrey Dunnick. Her second, and Coach Jason Ridge cannot believe it. It looked like Dunnick was standing perfectly still, and she just got flattened. Wayner back in for the Knights. And we've got another sub coming in. Sydney Crow back in for the Cougars. And it's Guy at the line shooting. Her first one in and out. Second one on the way is good. Guy's got three, all of them coming from the line. Left side now to Pate, inside now to Crow. She'll spin baseline, steps through the double team, and hits the left-handed layup. Crow with seven. Wayner with it once again for Marion. 4:20 to go here in the first half. Inside now to Guy. They'll double team her, and she throws it out of bounds. Whistle, and Perriman checks back in for the Knights, and she'll give Guy a break. So a smaller lineup on the court now for Marion. Dunnick with it now for St. Francis. She'll give it up to Pate. Now over to Turbin. Turbin now to Crawford. Crawford outside now to Dunnick. She wants to drive. Gets cut off there. Runs into Perriman. Gives it up to Crawford. She'll go up and under and hit the layup. Crawford with her fourth point of the game. The Cougars have cut the lead back down to 14. Here's Willoughby. Left side now to Wayner. She's going to fire a three, a high arching three, and she drains it. Wayner with her first bucket of the game and tipped out of bounds there by Collier. It'll stay with the Cougars. 3:36 to go here in the first half. And Elise Skaggs is going to come back on and give Crawford a break. Sydney Crow with the ball now. She'll give it up to Dunnick. Dunnick over to Pate. Pate has yet to even get a shot off in this game. She's a pretty good shooter. They'll look inside now for Skaggs. Skaggs posts up, turns baseline, gets double team, and a poor pass there by Skaggs is picked off by Marion. 11 turnovers on the Cougars here in the first half. Willoughby quickly to Collier. She'll fake, go baseline, gets double team. Back outside to Perriman. Perriman right through everybody, and she hits the layup. Perriman now with six. A 19-point lead for Marion. Sydney Crow with it now. She'll throw it up, left-handed again, misses it. Tipped off the fingertips of Collier and out of bounds. It'll stay with the Cougars. 2:49 to play here in the first half. Crow will look now. She'll give it up to Pate. Up top now to Turbin. Now to Skaggs. That ball's tipped and picked off. Coor the other way. She'll go right to the hoop, and she missed it. She was hit in the head by Dunnick. Dunnick will pick up her third, and that will send Marion to the line. And I don't know if they're going to call this maybe a flagrant foul. I don't know if they... Nope, they're just going to call it a common foul. That'll bring Hinton back in along with a Leatherman for St. Francis. Skaggs and Dunnick will check out. First one on the way is good. Second one on the way is line driving. It's good as well. McCour with four now in this game. And back in for Marion is Inman. Or excuse me, Amani Guy will check back in. And Marion has doubled up St. Francis here in the first half. Turbin picks up her dribble now and gives it to Pate. Now over to Hinton. Hinton gives it up to Leatherman. Leatherman fouled on the wrist there by Guy. That will be her second. Team's second of quarter number two. And there's a kick. It will stay with St. Francis with 2:18 to play here in the first half. And now they will get it into Turbin this time. She'll give it back to Hinton. Hinton gets cut off there by McCurry. Now she'll drive on her, throws it up with the right hand off the glass. No good. She'll shoot a pair. McQuay with the foul. Hinton at the line shooting. She's a 67% free throw shooter. Her first one will roll around and drop. Hinton now with five for St. Francis. Thought we had subs coming in for both teams here, but evidently not. Hinton's second one is short, tipped into the air, and goes off of Guy out of bounds. And now we will have some subs coming in, as Willoughby will check back in for Marion, and Sidney Crow will inbounds for St. Francis. So they'll put 20 seconds now on the shot clock. Crow looks, now gives it to Leatherman, has it tipped away and picked off by Marion. Here comes Marion the other way. Wehner with it now. Wehner now over to Collier. Inside now to Guy. She'll turn, she'll fire, and she'll hit it. Amani Guy now with five. 1:45 to play here in the first half. Pate with it now over to Turbin. Good look inside for Pate. She'll catch it now outside to Hinton. She'll launch a quick three. It's off the back of the iron. She'll get her own rebound. Good follow of her own shot. Here's Pate. Now she'll fire a long three. It's short. And Guy with another board. Here comes Marion the other way in transition. Downard now over to Willoughby. Willoughby in the lane, around everybody, over to Guy. She wasn't fouled. And they'll call. Now I think they are going to call a foul. And Jason Ridge really not happy with the officiating thus far in this game. They're going to call that, I believe, on Hinton. Hinton's going to pick up her second. Looked like a tie-up. Shooting two now for Marion is Amani Guy. She'll fire and hit it. And it looks like we're going to have a sub come in if she makes it. And they'll call a line violation on Collier of Marion. That'll bring back in Perriman and number 25, Bossy. Turbin to inbounds with 1:15 to go here in the first half. And it goes to Leatherman. Leatherman back to Turbin. That was a dangerous pass. Right side now to Hinton. Up top now to Leatherman. And now to Crow. 1 minute to go here in the first half. 13 on the shot clock. Leatherman with it outside to Payton. Now to Hinton. Ooh, she got, that was a dangerous play there. And I think friendly fire there as Perriman ran right over Collier. And they're going to call a foul on Collier. That'll be her first, but I don't think she actually meant to foul. I think Perriman actually ran into her, which sent her into the Cougars player. Sydney Crow to inbounds, 20 seconds on the shot clock, 52 on the game clock. Turbin catches it now, and over to Crow. Crow will give it back to Pate. Pate with the ball fake. 13 on the shot clock, and they'll reset it, and they're going to need to get going here. Sydney Crow wants a screen by Leatherman. She'll get a high screen. Picks up the dribble, fires it to Turbin. She's open for a three, and she nails it. Turbin with her first bucket of the game. About 9/10 of a second is the difference between the shot clock and the game clock right now. Donnard will hold on to the ball now for Marion. They lead big here in this game over St. Francis. Collier with it now, gets a screen, looks inside for Perriman, outside now to Willoughby. Her three is on the way, no good. Perriman with the offensive board. Willoughby's shot would have counted if it went in, and that will do it. We are headed to halftime. Marion 45, St. Francis 25. We'll take a timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the scoring in the first half. You're watching Cougars basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
Sure, we have to do this. A bit of a hill.
His mother said, if you're coming to school, you got to bring your sister because they have to go and work in the fields. So this kid carries his one-year-old sister everywhere.
A lot of those kids don't eat in the morning. A lot of those kids, the only place they do eat is at that school.
I thought going up that mountain, Mary's meals can reach everywhere that there's a hungry child.
Do you see what happens after a simple meal? It just came to life.
Love reaches everywhere.
Parkview Sports Medicine's integrated sports medicine team is built to serve the needs of all athletes in all sports. Our team's only goal is to improve athletes in every facet. PSM offers performance training to help athletes get better on the field, dedicated athletic rehabilitation and physical therapy to help them get better off of it. Certified athletic trainers in our PSM schools providing daily support to our athletes and a specialized orthopedic walk-in clinic when injury strikes. Call 260-266-4007 to speak to our care navigators or visit ParkviewSportsMedicine.com to learn more about what we can do to improve athletes at all levels. Parkview Sports Medicine. Become more.
Welcome to the Summit City, home to the 260's dedicated high school athletes and fans. Each victory and celebration captured by our cameras. Treasure the highlights from the Summit Athletic Conference this season or complete games live or on demand. After all, nobody's more proud to call Fort Wayne home than SummitCitySports.com.
Joint pain, sprains, strains, or a possible broken bone? Make the Parkview Ortho Express Walk-In Clinic your first stop when you have an orthopedic or sports injury. Parkview Ortho Express, located at the Sport One Parkview Fieldhouse, gives you access to quick care and orthopedic physicians when you need it most. Get x-rays, treatment, and referrals to Parkview Care, all in the convenience of a walk-in clinic. Call 260-266-4007 for more information.
I was once a Southside kid who was led on a journey by high school football. A journey that taught me discipline, toughness, and the skills that made me a success. As a businessman with a CPA license who owns his own firm, I still use the building blocks of high school sports in my everyday life. Someday sports will end no matter what level you reach. but you will be left with the skills to compete in the next game, the game of life.
Someday, you'll get your knee replaced. Someday, a new hip. Someday can be sooner than you think. At Parkview Ortho Hospital, we want to help you get moving again. So we offer a full range of options for joint pain, including outpatient joint replacements and personalized solutions. It's time to reclaim your life at Parkview Ortho Hospital, because someday is today. Learn more at parkview.com/ortho. Parkview, we believe in better.
Thank you for watching Summit City Sports. To help broaden our coverage, we're asking you to become a monthly sponsor to our Patreon account. We produce weekly highlights and live video broadcasts. When the Homestead girls golf team won its first state title in program history, we were there. When Fort Wayne brought back 3 state titles in cross country, we were there. We believe in sharing positive stories and setting the standard for how high school sports should be covered. Join us and donate today.
Keep it 100. Thank you.
This is an invitation to join a movement propelled by people who care and members who have a share in the place they bank.
Good morning, Sam.
So when you have the chance to get your first home loan, you know an expert will guide you every step of the way. Or when it's time to buy your new car, you'll be treated like more than just a credit score.
Good news, ProFed can get you that payment.
This is an invitation to a place where simply belonging can help enrich your whole community. ProFed Credit Union. You're invited.
Welcome back to the Hutzel Center here at the University of St. Francis. We are at halftime, 45-25 your score. Marian with the big lead over the Cougars. Looking at the scoring in the first half, first for Marian. They got 3 from Wayner, 6 from Perriman, 3 from Donard, They got four from McCurry. A team high 21 from Ella Collier. She's basically been unstoppable here in the first half. Sieb with two. And they've gotten, two, four, six from Amani Guy. And that's all the scoring in the first half for them. They are 9 of 15 from the foul line, and they turned the ball only over six times. For the Cougars, Cassidy Crawford with four, seven from Sydney Crow, five from Deja Hinton, two from Dunnick, four from Skaggs, and three from Alexis Turbin. They have not done a good job at the foul line. They are just 3 of 10 here in the first half, and the issue for the Cougars in the first half has been turnovers, 13 of them. And that's the reason why there's been so many extra buckets here in the first half for the Marian Knights. Looking at the conference standings going into today, Marian led the conference. They were 10-4 overall, 4-0 in conference play, and they've won four in a row, and they lead, and that's why they're ranked number 9 in the nation. Spring Harbor behind them, they haven't played very many games. They're 3-2 overall, 1-0 in conference play. Indiana Wesleyan checks in at number 3. They're 8-3 overall, 3-1 in conference play. Taylor behind them at 10-3 overall, 4-2 in conference play. This Cougars team's 8-4 overall, 2-1 in conference play. Huntington 4-2 overall, 1-1 in conference play. Mount Vernon is 3-6 overall, 1-2 in conference play. Goshen is 3-8. They are 1-3 in conference play. Bethel at 4-6 and 0-3 in conference play. And Grace, 8-5 overall, 0-4 in conference play. And Grace has won five games in a row this season. So they've kind of turned it around, just haven't been able to get it done in conference play thus far in the Crossroads League. For Marian, their next game after this one, they'll go Wednesday to Goshen at 7 p.m. And for the Cougars, they will travel about 45 minutes south of Fort Wayne. They will take on Huntington College at 7 p.m. down in at Huntington. They'll take on the Foresters down there. So we've still got about 4 minutes to go here in the pregame or the halftime here at the Hutzel Center. We will have college basketball for you again on Monday night. It'll be men's action. They will be here at the Hutzel Center. And we'll take a look at who they will be playing in just a second here. We're waiting for it to load up, and there we go. And they will take on Bethel. And I believe that says that's a 5 o'clock start here at the Hutzel Center. Let me make sure that is correct. If that's the right date is what I'm trying to confirm. Yeah, Monday the 4th at 5 o'clock, they will take on Bethel University. And then they will be right back here at home again on Wednesday as they will take on Huntington University. This is the men's team, and then they will finish up the week at Spring Harbor. So three games for the guys this week. We'll take our final timeout here at halftime at the Hutzel Center. When we come back, we will have the start of the second half. You're watching Cougars basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
I was once a Southside kid who was led on a journey by high school football. A journey that taught me discipline, toughness, and the skills that made me a success. As a businessman with a CPA license who owns his own firm, I still use the building blocks of high school sports in my everyday life. Someday sports will end no matter what level you reach, but you will be left with the skills to compete in the next game, the game of life.
This is an invitation to join a movement propelled by people who care and members who have a share in the place they bank.
Good morning, Sam.
So when you have the chance to get your first home loan, you know an expert will guide you every step of the way. Or when it's time to buy your new car, you'll be treated like more than just a credit score.
Good news, ProFed can get you that payment.
This is an invitation to a place where simply belonging can help enrich your whole community. ProFed Credit Union. You're invited.
Welcome back here to the Hutzel Center. The teams are finishing up their warm-ups here. And interesting, the Cougars are at the line shooting free throws. And a quick score up from college football. It is Ole Miss with a 13-3 lead over Indiana with about a minute 35 to go in the first half. You had a pretty good football season themselves, and St. Francis looking to kick off their football season here in the spring this year. They will play over at Darcy Stadium, and hopefully they'll have good weather here in the spring. Last spring here in Northeast Indiana, pretty doggone good. If they can get that kind of weather this year, which was dry and for the most part in the 30s and 40s, good football weather for Coach Donnelly and his Cougars football team. We're set and ready to go. Looks like St. Francis will go with their original starters, Turbin, Hinton, Crow, Crawford, and Leatherman. We'll see who Marion brings out. It looks like it's going to be Guy, along with Collier, Willoughby, Perriman, and Donnard. That's Donnard. That is their original starters as well. Cougars will have the ball, and we are ready to go here for second half action at the Hutzel Center. Cougars need to try to cut this lead down to 10 if they can by the end of this quarter to try to stay in this game against the number 9 ranked team in the country. It is Crow with the ball now. She'll give it up to Turbin. Turbin looks inside. Hag Crawford now finds her. She'll go up strong and hits the bucket. Good start for St. Francis. A good set play to get them started here in the second half. Willoughby with the ball now for the Knights. Donnard with it. She'll get a high screen there. Good look inside, not a Guy. Guy gets bumped, and they're going to call a foul on Turbin. Turbin gets her first, team's first here in this second half. It'll be Donnard inbounds. Fresh 20 on the shot clock now for Marion. Inbounded now to Willoughby, and she traveled. She took an extra step. That's just the seventh turnover by Marion in this game. And now Marion will pick up full court once again. Katie Gerald's up off the bench telling her girls to get up the court. Crawford to inbounds. And they'll throw it away. Donnard picks off another one. Now she'll turn the corner, go behind her back, kicks it outside to Collier. Collier with 21 in the first half, and she'll go strong to the hoop. She's fouled on the hip, and she might have twisted an ankle. That foul's going to be on Hinton. Collier walks gingerly to the line to shoot, and let's see. Sorry about the technical difficulties there. Now we got the screen back up. You can see what's going on here. Collier hit those two free throws just a minute ago. She's got 23 in the game. Crow gets bumped away from the ball by Guy. If that's on Guy, that is actually, that's on Imani Guy. That should be her third. They have her for two. Hinton to inbounds now for St. Francis. Somebody's got to come to the ball, and Collier going to get hit with the foul. Collier's second. Team's second here in the third quarter. Sydney Crow to inbounds now for St. Francis. 8:38 to play here in quarter number three. Crow will get it back now from Crawford. Turbin will pop out, looks inside, finds Crawford. Crawford gets bumped, now picks up her dribble, throws it to Hinton with 10 on the shot clock. She's bumped there by Guy, and Guy will get hit with her third personal, and that'll send Deja Hinton to the line to shoot a pair for the Cougars. And Gerard will get up off the bench now for Marion. Looks like she's going to come in and replace Guy. And Hinton now, she'll eye the first one. And fires, and it's off the back of the iron. No good. The Cougars struggling from the line here today. Just 3 of 12. Hinton second is no good. Leatherman with the rebound for St. Francis. Turbin with it now, and they'll look inside for Leatherman, and it's kicked and picked off there by Marion, but they'll reset the shot clock to a fresh 20 as well. The sub coming in now for Marion. Number 21, side back in, and she'll replace Perriman. Crow to inbounds for St. Francis. And they're going to call a pushing foul on Crawford. And that'll be her third. So Marion with the ball trying to extend their 20-point lead here as they'll let Willoughby handle the rock now. And Donnard with it. Donnard will get a high screen there by Gerard. Now over to Willoughby. Back in the corner to Donnard with 10 on the shot clock. Skip pass to Collier. Gerard will have position inside. Now gets double teamed. Back to Collier. Collier will go underneath. Throws it outside to Donnard. And it's no good. Crawford with the board. Crawford will push it ahead now to Crow. Crow on the left side of the lane, goes up with the left hand. She's fouled by Willoughby. Willoughby's going to pick up her first. Sydney Crow, she will shoot a pair for St. Francis. Her first one is good. Crow now with 8. Second one is good as well. We'll skip it over now to Collier. She'll look inside. Gerard has it. Gets double-teamed. Outside now to Willoughby. She'll fire a long three. It's going to be an air ball, but it comes down to Donnard. Outside now to Collier. She'll fire another three, and it's an air ball. Back-to-back air balls by Marion, and up quickly comes Hinton for St. Francis. She'll look inside now for Leatherman. She'll spin baseline. Gets partially blocked, and they're either going to call Gerard or Collier with the foul. And they'll get Collier with the foul. And that'll be her third. Dunnick and Pate coming in for St. Francis. They'll replace Hinton and Turbin. McQuay in for Marian. She'll replace Collier. Leatherman to shoot. And she hits the first one. That's Leatherman's first points of the afternoon. She'll fire the second. Off the back of the iron, no good. And she'll battle for it, and they'll say off of Leatherman. It'll go to Marian. Timeout on the court. Marian, we'll see if it's a full or a 30 here. Waiting for our official to give us the... And it is a 30-second timeout. We'll see you in 30 seconds. Welcome back here to the Hutzel Center. 7:09 to go here in quarter number three. Cougars trail by 17. It's Willoughby with the ball for Marian. They're going to run out and put a double team on her. She'll quickly give it up to Donnard. Donnard skip pass over to McQuay. McQuay now dribbles, picks up her dribble. Looks inside, good pass, and blocked by Crawford. Sieb had a good look at the bucket, but Crawford just was in the right spot at the right time. 16 seconds on the shot clock now for Marian. And Donnard with it. Donnard looks inside, and they're going to call a hold, I believe, on Sydney Crow. They are. Her first, team's fourth. Donnard now will inbounds to McQuay. McQuay has it slapped out of bounds off of her foot. Good defense there by Crawford. Crow with it now for St. Francis. She'll give it up. She's looking to give it up to Dunnick. Now over to Pate. Back to Crawford, and she'll swing it now to Dunnick. Dunnick wants to drive, spins, goes up strong, misses everything. Leatherman catches it. Gets blocked from behind by Gerard. Here comes Marion's Willoughby with the ball. And a long three by Sieve is off the back of the iron. No good. And Crow with the board now for St. Francis. Quickly to Dunnick. Dunnick with a bounce pass inside. Good look inside now to Crawford. She'll catch it, goes up on McQuay, and hits a shot. Cassidy Crawford with the bucket, and she'll shoot the and one. On McQuay, that will be her third. Good strength here by Crawford. McQuay will check out for Marian and Wayner back in. Crawford with a chance to cut into this lead. Crawford on the season, a 64% foul shooter. And she said off as soon as she let go of it, but it went right in. Here's Wayner now for Marian to Donnard. Donnard looks inside, now outside to Willoughby. She'll fire another three, no good. Dunnick with the board for St. Francis. Here comes Crawford for the Cougars. She'll drive, gets cut off, now fires it up off the iron, no good. Comes down now to Gerard. She'll give it up to Downard, and nobody picks her up. Now they do, and she'll look inside for Gerard. Gerard goes up, she's fouled, and she hits the shot. And Gerard with her first bucket of the game. Pate will pick up the foul, her first in the game. And now both teams will be shooting two shots the rest of this quarter. Her free throw is good. The lead back to 15. Crawford now right side to Dunnick. Dunnick will get a screen. Looks inside for Crawford. Now back over to Skaggs, who's into the game. Skip pass now to Crow. Over to Pate. Her shot is blocked out of bounds by Downard. Boss back into the game now for Marion. 12 on the shot clock, 5:20 in the third quarter. Crawford catches it, bounce pass to Dunnick. She'll go up strong, and she is fouled by Wehner. Wehner's first. Back to the line, shooting is Dunnick. Dunnick fires the first one, no good. She's had a rough day at the line. Second one, no good as well. Rebounded there by Sieb. She'll give it up now to Wehner. Wehner to Boss. Boss with the crossover. Back to Wehner. She'll fire a three. It's no good. Crawford fights for the rebound, and we'll have a tie-up, and it will go to Marion. Hinton up off the bench now for St. Francis. She'll check back in. Crow will check out as Hinton comes in. Downard inbounds now to Sieb. Sieb has it deflected but gets it right back. She'll give it up to Wehner. Wehner to Downard. Downard now picked up there by Skaggs. Now Pate will get out on her. Kicks it outside now to Wehner. Wehner back to Downard. Downard to the hoop. Good pass to Sieb. Sieb with her fourth point of the game. Crawford has that shot blocked by Boss, and she'll give it up to Wehner. Now ahead now to Downard. Back to Sieb, and we're going to have a foul on the floor as they'll get Elise Skaggs with the foul. That'll be her second, and that will send, I believe, Gerard to the line to shoot a pair. This will be the 19th and 20th foul shots coming for Marion. Difference in this game is probably foul shots. St. Francis has not hit many of their 19. That one's off the back of the iron, no good. Gerard to shoot the second. She'll fire, no good. Rebounded there by Skaggs. Skaggs will give it up quickly to Dunnick. Dunnick now into the front court now for the Cougars. And she'll turn and give it to Skaggs. Skaggs looks inside for Crawford, up off the glass, and she is fouled on the play, and she hits the bucket. Downard will pick up the foul, her first of the game. And you see a good high-low here by St. Francis. Good entry pass there by Skaggs. Crawford will fire the free throw and hit it. She's got 12 in this game, and the Cougars trail by 16. Downard looks inside for Gerard. Skip pass to Boss. She'll fire the three. No good. Dunnick loses. Nope, I think they're going to say off of it. No, they say Wehner didn't touch it off of Dunnick. It'll be Downer to inbounds now for Marion. 3:53 to go here in this third quarter. She looks, gives it to Gerard, right back to Downard. And back inside now. Gerard double teamed. 10 seconds on the shot clock. And Downard looks and gets a screen by Sieb. She'll drive. Good D there by Dunnick. Dunnick, what a good play there by Downard, the senior. Used her body to keep the defense off, and she was able to throw it in off the glass. Crawford wants to go a little one-on-one here with Girard. Now kicks it over to Pate. Pate goes baseline, stops, gives it back to Crawford, now to Dunnick. Dunnick threw a bunch of players. She's fouled on the wrist. She'll go back to the line to shoot. We'll see who the Marian fouls on. It's on number 25, Boss, her first. Perriman will check back in for Marian and replace Sieb. Dunnick's free throw on the way is good. Second one good as well. Lead back to 16 now for Marian. 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Good look inside for Girard. She goes up strong, has it partially blocked. Dunnick pulls it away, and here comes St. Francis. Can they get it to within 10? And almost a turnover. Pate looks inside, finds Skaggs. Skaggs skip pass now to Hinton. Hinton back outside to Crawford. Inside now to Skaggs. Skaggs with a good pass to Dunnick. Now over to Pate. She'll fire the quick three and off the iron. That ball gets tipped. Skaggs with the board for St. Francis. Dunnick now to the rack, off the glass, and she is fouled by Boss. The foul shot's number 23-24 for St. Francis. We've got a whistle, and here comes Turbin and a Leatherman back in. They'll replace Peyton Crawford. Dunnick back at the line. She has been there all afternoon. That one's no good. And here's the second one by Dunnick, and it's good. And we have a sub coming in. Looks like Sieb will come in for Girard, and it'll be Crow back in for St. Francis. 2:34 to go here in the third quarter. Can the Cougars cut this to a 10-point lead before we get to the fourth quarter? They just put some fresh legs back out there. Wehner with it now. Over to Downard. She'll drive baseline on Turbin, gets it, and turns it over. Good defense there by Skaggs. Oh, and then Skaggs wanted to throw it ahead to Hinton, and Wehner jumped the passing lane, and Skaggs traveled. Downer to inbounds with 2:15 to play in quarter number three. She'll have Sieb standing right in front of her. She looks to get it to Boss, now to Sieb. Sieb now to Wehner. Wehner to Downard. And a push in the back on Turbin. Her second, and that will send, I think, Perriman to line to shoot a pair. It is Perriman. Long third quarter here at the Hutzel Center with all the fouls. Perriman's free throw is good. Perriman hits the second. Now Marion's got Crow trapped, and she is fouled there by Perriman. And that should send St. Francis the other way to shoot. I believe it will be Sydney Crow. Crow at the line. She'll fire, and she'll hit it. Crow's second one, no good. Perriman with the rebound for Marian. Now she quickly goes the other way. She'll go right at Turbin. Goes to the rack, and she is fouled by Turbin. Willoughby checks back in. She'll replace Boss for Marian. And that one's off the mark for Perriman. We've had over 50 free throws in this game already, and we still have a quarter to play. The second one by Perriman is good. Lead back to 17. Here's Skaggs with it quickly to Leatherman. Leatherman back over now to Crow. Crow will set up the offense with 20 seconds to go here in their possession. Skaggs looks inside for Leatherman. She gets double teamed, faces up, kicks it to Hinton. Hinton now over to Crow. Crow goes baseline, steps through a double team, throws it up, no good, gets her own board, fouled from behind by number three, Downard. That'll send Crow back to the line to shoot for St. Francis. Gerard will check back in for Marian, and she'll replace Perriman. Crow will fire, and she'll nail it. Sydney Crow now with 11. Second one on the way, no good. Good block out there by Gerard. She actually blocked out her Leatherman and Wainer on that play. 1:20 to go here in quarter number three. Wainer will back it out between the circles. Looks over at head coach Katie Gerald's, and now they'll figure out which play they want to run. Sieb will come out and set a high screen, and now they'll swing it all the way over to Downard and back up top to Willoughby. Willoughby over to Wainer. She'll go baseline, gets cut off, throws it out to Downard, and that's a shot clock violation on Marian. Good defense by the Cougars. Cougars will bring back in Pate and Dunnick, and they'll replace Turbin and Hinton. Sydney Crow with the ball now for St. Francis. Less than a minute to go here in the third quarter. Dunnick with it now, back to Crow, and they'll reset the offense. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Dunnick now to Skaggs. Skaggs over to Pate. She's going to fire a three, and she drains it. Reagan Pate with her first bucket of the game. Seven seconds difference between shot clock and game clock. 16 on the shot clock. Can the Cougars get a stop here? Downard outside now to Willoughby. She's going to fire a three. Oh, what a shot by Willoughby. A dagger. It's 5 seconds. Dunnick now the other way. She can see the clock. Stops, fires a 15-footer, and it goes in. Dunnick with her first field goal of the game, and we'll head to the fourth quarter. You're watching girls college basketball live from the Hutzel Center.
Thank you for watching Summit City Sports. To help broaden our coverage, we're asking you to become a monthly sponsor to our Patreon account. We believe in sharing positive stories and are excited to set the standard for how high school sports should be covered. Join us and donate today.
Welcome back here to the Hutzel Center. We are set to go here for the fourth quarter. Marian enjoys a 14-point lead as we get ready to play the final quarter here at St. Francis. Hopefully, we will eliminate some of the foul shooting that we've had in this game. Between the two teams, nearly 60 foul shots have already been shot in this game. Crow now will go to Skaggs. Skaggs up top, now to Leatherman. Leatherman, right side, now to Crow. Crow looks inside for Skaggs. Skip pass, now to Pate. 15 on the shot clock, and it goes right to Skaggs. Good bounce pass to Dunnick. She goes up strong and hits the shot. Dunnick, like a bull in a china shop, right to the rack. She flexes some muscle after that one. Good look inside, now to Guy. She'll go with the right-handed layup, and she hits it. Guy has sat most of that quarter with her fouls. Right side now to Leatherman. She'll give it to Dunnick. Dunnick inside now to Skaggs. Skaggs steps through a double team. Turns, nobody picks her up, and she fires and hits it. Skaggs was six. Collier didn't close out on her, so she just took the jumper. Collier also sat most of that third quarter with her three fouls. Here is Collier with the ball now. She'll look inside for Guy. Guy turns, kicks it to Willoughby, and she was out of bounds, and it's a turnover on Marian. 12-point lead now for Marian. St. Francis, every possession counts from this point. And a timeout on the court, Marian. And it's a full timeout. We'll see you in a minute. You're watching Cougars basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
Joint pain, sprains, strains, or a possible broken bone? Make the Parkview Ortho Express Walk-In Clinic your first stop when you have an orthopedic or sports injury. Call 260-266-4007 for more information.
For every victory, for every highlight, for every team in the Summit Athletic Conference, we've got you covered. Like, follow, and subscribe for all the latest.
My name is Nick Ferrer. I was part of the two-time national championship football team. I graduated from St. Francis with a business degree in risk management insurance. That led me to my internship here at Highland, and that internship became a full-time position as an account manager here at Highland. And if it wasn't for University of St. Francis and the education and the skills that I learned there, I wouldn't be where I'm at today in my career.
Timeout over here on the court. We've got 8:53 to play. It'll be St. Francis with the ball when we resume here. They trail by 12. They've trailed by as many as 22 points here in the second half. They've cut it to 12 now. Can they keep it up? And now Marion's going to come up and pick up full court once again. Dunnick to inbounds. She'll get it in now to Crow and right back to Dunnick. Dunnick now looks inside for Leatherman. She's being guarded there by Sieb. Sieb going to get hit with the foul on the reach. That will be her first, team's first here in the fourth quarter. Sydney Crow to inbounds now for St. Francis. She'll throw it up top now to Dunnick between the circles. Nobody comes out to guard Dunnick. They're just daring her to shoot. She'll dribble into traffic. Now kick it around now to Leatherman. Inside now to Lee Skaggs. Skaggs traveled. 15 turnovers on St. Francis. That'll bring in Perriman back in. She'll replace Sieb. Downard with the ball now for Marian. She'll give it up to Collier. She'll get a double high screen. Good look inside to the two guy, and she hits the shot. Great set play there by Marian. Guy now with 10. Leatherman looks inside for Skaggs. Hatter now outside, now to Dunnick. Dunnick wants to drive, kicks it now to Crow. And back to Dunnick. They're just daring her to shoot. 10 seconds on the shot clock. It's Pate with the ball. Looks inside now for Skaggs. Skaggs over to Crow. Crow kicks it back to Dunnick with 3, and she'll fire it, and it's off the iron. No good. Rebounded there by Leatherman. Good offensive board. Dunnick now back over to Crow. Her 3-ball on the way is no good. Perriman with the rebound for Marian. They lead by 14 with 7:35 to play. Quick shot by Willoughby is on the way. No good. Down goes both Perriman and Dunnick, and they'll say Perriman loses it out of bounds. That'll bring Hinton back on for Dunnick. Here's Sidney Crow with the ball now for St. Francis. Looks like St. Francis is going to try to get Crawford back into this lineup sooner rather than later. Leatherman inside now to Skaggs. Skaggs double team now goes to the hoop. She is fouled from behind by, I believe, Perriman. They will call that on Perriman from behind. I think Crawford going to come in for Skaggs if she can hit both of these. Skaggs first one off the rim and drops in. Skaggs now with 7. Skaggs will fire the second. Same thing. She's got 8. Cassidy Crawford will replace her. Turbin will come in now for give Crow a quick break. Perriman inbounds now with 7:16 to play here in the final quarter. Collier around the screen here. Looks inside for Guy again. She'll go up strong. Misses it. And right there is, I'm not sure how that's not a foul, as Crawford had it. And if they call a jump ball, they're going to call a jump ball. My goodness, Guy came around out of nowhere. That was a bad call by the officials. I don't know how he missed that when he was standing right there. Now, I agree that the first defender there, Perriman, wasn't fouling, but certainly Guy was. Inbounded now to Perriman. She'll drive to the hoop. Now gives it up to Donard. Too many players on that left side. Now they'll clear out. Now double team coming now on Guy. Good bounce pass to Perriman. Hits her right in the left foot. Comes up with it. 17 on the shot clock. Collier with the ball. Collier now in the lane. She's been quiet here in the second half, and she's fouled, and she'll shoot a pair. That is on, let's see here. I thought they said Crawford. Pate will come out now. They still have not posted who that foul was on. Was definitely not on Crow then. That foul shot good by Collier. Collier with 24, make it 25. Collier, a pretty good freshman here for Marian. She's been the leading scorer, and here's a foul called on Inman, or on Imani Guy. Her fourth. And Katie Gerald's wanting to know what she did to deserve that. And here comes Gerard back in for Guy. And a couple coaches getting on Guy saying that was 40 feet away from the basket. Here's Crawford with it now. She'll give it up to Turbin. Now over to Crow. She'll look inside. She's got Crawford. Crawford goes baseline, swings it. And now it'll come all the way back around to a wide open Crow. No good. Hinton with the offensive board. She came all the way from that wing position to get it. Crawford misses it. Leatherman catches it and puts it back in for the Cougars. And we've got ourselves a 12-point game with 6:10 to play. Collier with it now. She'll give it to Willoughby. Back over to Downard. Downard wants to drive now with the pass to Collier, who's open for three. She is human. She missed one. Quick outlet now to Crow. Cougars can get this into single digits. Underneath now to Leatherman. She'll turn and no foul called there. And Jason Ridge about ready to explode. Collier the other way goes right to the rack. Stops, fires, and it rolls in. And we've got a timeout on the court of Marion. And I believe it's just a 30-second timeout. Don't forget, we'll stay right here during this timeout. Monday night, we will be back here at the Hutzel Center at 5 o'clock. It'll be men's basketball here at the Hutzel Center. Let's see if I can jump back over there and figure out who they're playing once again on Monday. It'll be Bethel. So Bethel will invade the Hutzel Center and take on the Cougars. And we take a look at the standings. Bethel in second place in the Crossroads League. They're 10-2 overall. Indiana Wesleyan 16-0 already in men's basketball. St. Francis at 13-1. So heck of a matchup here Monday night at the Hutzel Center. We've got 5:34 to play. The Cougars trail by 14. Can they get back into this one? It'll be Cassidy Crawford to inbounds. And Hinton with it now. Neither team really in foul trouble here in this fourth quarter. Crow with 20 seconds over to Hinton. Hinton looks, gives it up to Turbin. Turbin now to Crow. Back to Turbin. She'll fire a long three. It's short, comes down to Leatherman. Leatherman outside to Crow. Crow drives to the hoop, gets bumped, off the glass, no good. Gerard comes up with a loose ball. And we'll see if Marion tries to run some clock with this possession. Gerard inside, now to Perriman. She gets the lane, goes up, misses it, and Crow with the rebound. She'll push it up quickly now to Hinton. Hinton inside, now to Crawford. Had great position. She'll go up strong and hit the bucket. Crawford now with 14 for St. Francis. And we've got a hold called on, I believe, Turbin. It is on Turbin, and that is her fourth. And we'll see if Coach Jason Ridge goes to Skaggs or maybe even Pate here. Inbounded now to Willoughby. And back outside to Willoughby. She'll fire it. And it's off the side of the backboard. And only 9 seconds on the shot clock. It's Collier with the ball. And they did reset the time clock. They say it did hit the rim. They'll look inside for now for Gerard. She's double teamed. Kicked over now to, easy bucket there. McQuay with the easy one for Marion. Under 4 minutes to play. Inside once again to Crawford. She'll kick it outside now to Turbin. She'll fire another three. Gets partially blocked. Comes down to Marion. McQuay with it. She'll go up and under, and it'll roll around and go in. Over now to Crow. Inside now to Crawford. Crawford outside now to Hinton. She'll fire the three. It's going to be short. McQuay with the rebound. She'll bring it up into the front court. Kicks it over to Collier. Collier wants to split a double team. Comes up with it. Gives it up to Gerard. Loose ball in the court. And it comes to Willoughby with 15 on the shot clock. Outside now to Collier. Collier gets a screen, now picks up a dribble and gives it up to Perriman. Perriman off the glass, and she's flattened, and she went down hard on her right knee. And we have a timeout on the court. Well, looks like Perriman's going to be okay. They sent both teams to their benches, but I think we're going to restart. Skaggs will come in, I believe. I thought I heard, Elise Skaggs is into the game now for St. Francis. 18-point lead. Crawford with the ball for St. Francis. 2:30 to play. And I hear the head coach, Katie Gerald's yelling, move your feet. She does not want any fouls. 9 on the shot clock. Here's Crawford now to Skaggs. Skaggs looks, now drives. Spins, has it blocked. She gets her own ball back, and it's going to be a shot clock violation on St. Francis. And they're debating whether this should be a shot clock violation here. We'll wait to get the final verdict from our three officials. So we do have a timeout on the court, St. Francis, but they explained during that we have a foul called on number 13, Collier, on a hold, and it will be St. Francis's ball with 20 seconds on the shot clock. Looks like it was on the scramble to get that loose ball off the block that they called Collier with the foul, and Katie Gerald's, she doesn't agree, and both coaches have not been real happy with their officiating here this afternoon. She's like, yeah, my girl got flattened on this end and he didn't call anything, and you're going to call a little hold on the other end, and she's still working the officials right in front of us. Cougars ball now with 2:13 to play. It'll be Sydney Crow to inbounds. Inbounded now to Crawford. Back to Crow. She'll Pate look for the screen. Now Crow's post, or Crawford posting up, and we have a hold called on Perriman. It was a good call by the official. You could see Perriman just push Crawford out of the lane. And I believe that may send the Cougars the line to shoot two. It is a 16 foul. So Crawford back at the line. Free throw on the way is no good. Looks like Crawford barely can get anything on that. She'll shoot the second. Hits the front of the iron and drops in. She's got 15. Willoughby now with 2 minutes to play. Jason Ridge just yells out, play good defense here, no fouls. And that ball's tipped away. Quay now to Gerard. Gerard in the lane, off the glass, misses it. McQuay with the offensive board. She'll dribble right to the hoop and hit the shot. McQuay with 10 now. Right side now to Hinton. She'll look inside for Crow. Back over to Crawford. Crawford's going to get, actually they're going to hit Elise Skaggs with an illegal screen. And if that's on Skaggs, that will be her fourth. And Gerard will inbounds now for Marion. 1:17 to play. Both of these teams in action on Wednesday. Marion will go to Goshen. That game at 7. And the Cougars, they will travel down to Huntington to take on the Foresters at 7 o'clock Wednesday night. Here's Collier again. She'll stop, she'll pop, she'll hit. Collier with 29. 1 minute to play here at the Hutzel Center. Subs coming in for Marion at the next whistle. Right side now to Crow. Crow will get a screen. Now over to Hinton. Hinton drives baseline, gets cut off, fires it outside to Peyton in the corner and out of Skaggs. Skaggs with 10 seconds. She goes up strong, hits the side of the iron, no good. Girard with the rebound. 35 seconds to play. Willoughby now gets a screen, now gives it up to Collier. Collier going to be your Parkview Sports Medicine player of the game this evening, or this afternoon, with 29 points for the freshman. She started off hot. She had 7 of their first 10, and she never looked back. Here's Willoughby's runner, and it's good. Willoughby now with 5. And here's St. Francis with the ball. Crow will throw it up off the glass. And Crawford's shot is blocked. And your final this afternoon at the Hutzel Center, it is Marion with a big win on the road. They win 80-57 over St. Francis. Give me just a second here, and we'll run down the scoring here in this game, and then we'll let you all have a good afternoon. For Marion, they improved to 11-4 overall, 5-0 in conference play. 3 from Wayner, 11 from Perriman, 5 from Downard, 10 from McQuay, 29 from Ella Collier, the freshman, Seba with 4, 10 from Guy, 5 from Willoughby, and 3 from Girard. And from the foul line, they went 15 of 26 for the game. And they will play Wednesday at Goshen at 7 o'clock. For the Cougars, they will drop to 8-5 overall in the season, 2-2 in conference play. They got a team high 15 from Crawford. They got from Sidney Crow 11, 5 from Hinton, 9 from Dunnick, 3 from Leatherman, 3 from Pate, 8 from Skaggs, and 3 from Turbin. Rough night at the foul line for St. Francis. They went 16 of 32, good for 50% in the game. So they'll need to work on that before they play Wednesday down at Huntington at 7 o'clock. That does it here from the Hutzel Center. Marion with a good road win this afternoon. They win today 80-57 over St. Francis. Everybody have a good afternoon. We'll see you Monday here at 5 o'clock as the boys will play Bethel. Your final today, 80-57, Marion. Have a good afternoon, and we'll see you Monday. You're watching Cougars basketball live from the University of St. Francis.
Developing athletes to be foundationally strong. Healthy and consistent training. Expert staff. Long-term athletic development. Parkview Sports Medicine Performance. Any athlete, any age, any skill level.
Thank you for watching Summit City Sports. To help broaden our coverage, we're asking you to become a monthly sponsor to our Patreon account. We produce weekly highlights and live video broadcasts. When the Homestead girls golf team won its first state title in program history, we were there. When Fort Wayne brought back 3 state titles in cross country, We were there. We believe in sharing positive stories and setting the standard for how high school sports should be covered. Join us and donate today.
I chose St. Francis because they made a promise that I would have real world experience that I could take when I graduated, and they delivered on that promise. For me, the classroom only gets you so far. So they're setting you up with an internship. I had a mentor that they set me up with that was a CEO of a DuPont hospital in Fort Wayne.
They offer degrees in accounting, business administration, risk management and insurance, marketing, and finance.
You know, they just did a great job of the full circle of not only the education, but also the experience.